Tackling the non-existent problem of voter fraud, Republicans insist, is necessary to protect electoral integrity. Now those efforts have brought them one step closer to rigging the vote in the Keystone State, where more than 9% of the electorate lacks a ticket to the ballot box, a valid photo ID. In a ruling yesterday, Pennsylvania Commonwealth Court Judge Robert Simpson refused to block the Republican-penned voter ID law from taking effect this November. While expressing some sympathy for the arguments of the plaintiffs, Simpson ultimately agreed with the state's argument that the law should not be struck down merely because it inconveniences some voters. He said in his opinion, "I am not convinced any qualified elector need be disenfranchised by Act 18. Based on the availability of absentee voting, provisional ballots, and opportunities for judicial relief for those with special hardships, I'm not convinced any of the individual petitioners or other witnesses will not have their votes counted in the general election." Remarkably, the state admitted in its papers there has been no investigation, prosecution, or instance of in-person voter fraud. None, not one. This was a statute in desperate search of a problem. The ACLU is expected to appeal the ruling to the state Supreme Court. Joining me now is Christopher Broach, an elections judge in Delaware County, Pennsylvania, who vows to fight the voter ID law by not enforcing it at the polls this November. Also with me is Mike Papantonio, president of the National Trial Lawyers Association, host of Ring of Fire Radio. Thank both of you for joining us tonight. Mike, let me start with you. I'm mystified by this. Not one piece of evidence that there is even a voter fraud problem, yet a judge permits this massive encumbrance on the right to vote to be upheld constitutionally. Does this surprise you?
Eliot, I hate to say it, but this is what happens when political hacks dress up in black robes and call themselves judges. Wow. They're still ideologues, unfortunately. This judge had everything he needed in the way of evidence, in the way of testimony, to grant a restraining order, in joining the enforcement of this Republican voter scam. That's all this is. First of all, he had part of the Pennsylvania Constitution that's even more deliberate. It's more explicit than the 14th Amendment. He had the Pennsylvania Constitution language that made it clear that every election should be conducted in a way that's both free and free of restrictions and equal to all voters, every color, every age. He had everything he needed, and he chose not to do it. I suppose relying on the Supreme Court's decision from Indiana, which had no bearing on the evidence that he heard in this case.
Mike, I want to keep this short because I want to get to Christopher real soon. But it seems to me that in a context like this, a judge is supposed to weigh and balance the equities. Here you have the prospect that up to 9% of the voters in the state will be forbidden from voting. And you have absolutely no evidence of a single instance. The state admitted not one piece of evidence of fraud. So you're not protecting the state against anything. On the other side, an encumbrance to a our most vital constitutional right. It seems like an insane decision to me.
It was a very poor decision. And if he had not had so much testimony, Governor, he had not so much evidence in front of him that made it clear that there was no problem here, that this was an all-out effort by the Republicans to get in the way of people's right to vote.
Yep. All right. Well, Christopher, let's come to you. You're actually going to do something about this. I've heard that you're, as an election judge, going to not enforce. You're saying, you know what, this law is not constitutional. It's not proper. Do you still plan not to enforce the statute?
Well, good evening, Governor Spitzer. I absolutely intend not to enforce this outrageous law.
And have you spoken to others who are in your position, other election judges who likewise will permit people to show up if they have other ID and vote and as they have in the past?
I haven't actually spoken to other election judges or inspectors of elections specifically who have given me their own opinions, even though I have read that there is a Republican inspector of elections in Radnor, Pennsylvania, which actually isn't too far from me, who pretty much has the same opinion that I have with respect to the law. She didn't say that she's not going to enforce it, but again, even the people that are going to be working in the same precincts as myself, I'm going to let them do what they think is necessary. But as the judge of elections, I'm going to actually pass judgment on this ruling, and I'm going to enforce what I believe is fair and impartial to make sure that I'm not going to do Governor Corbett's dirty work.
Right. Look, as the record has made clear, there is not a single instance in the state of Pennsylvania of in-person voting fraud anywhere, anytime that anybody can point to. So it's not as though there's an issue to be addressed. Has anybody called you and said, hey, you know what, we've heard you're not planning to enforce the law. There are going to be consequences, repercussions of some sort that will be up for you.
Well, I've had a few radio show hosts actually say that they hope that I go to jail. They actually suggested to me that they thought that Martin Luther King and Rosa Parks actually wanted to go to jail. And I mean, that made my resolve even stronger to say that I don't think anybody wants to go to jail. We want to be able to have our rights protected. And these rights, like the Voting Rights Act that's been around since the same year that I was born, absolutely have been ignored by this judge and by this court and these lawmakers.
You know, Mike, let me come back to you for a second. What do you make of the judge's assertion that nobody will lose the right to vote? There is recourse in the form of an absentee ballot, provisional ballots. He's basically saying, look, if you show up without the requisite ID, then there'll be some other way for you to get your vote counted. Do you buy that as a factual matter, or will this just keep people from showing up?
The only evidence was clear that there's sub-scams here, Governor. One of the sub-scams is to make it more difficult for a voter to get things like having a birth certificate reissued. The other scam is to put the place where they register 10 or 15 miles away from a central city, from the center of city, where it makes it difficult for people to even register. The other part of the scam that the Republicans are pulling off up there is to make the registration effort even more difficult by closing the office to where it's only open certain days at certain times, in reducing the number of staff, reducing the number of offices where a person can register. So this judge had more information than he needed. He simply was an ideologue. There's no other way to look at this. He might have complimented the ACLU. He might have said, you did a good job. But you know what? I interviewed people early on, and they were telling me this is going to be a fair judge. All I had to do was look at the background. I understood he was going to be a predictable ideologue, and that's all he is here.
Christopher, let me come back to you real quick.
Sure.
Do you know, or have you seen, that there's an effort to reach out to voters who might now be fearful or at least hesitant about showing up because they don't have the right ID? Is there an effort to make sure people can get that ID or at least find out how to do so to minimize the impact of what I think is really an unfortunate ruling?
Well, I haven't seen any outreach from anybody at the state level. In fact, I'm kind of surprised that even the governor suggested that they had enough money to be able to do these things. When in fact they've taken that money from the schools. At the same time, I've not seen any ads on television. I haven't heard any ads on the radio. However, we're going to start our own process out in Colwyn, where we're going to actually not only register people to vote, because I do that every summer, but we're actually going to pick people up and we're going to drive them to the DMV to get their photo ID, just to make sure that they're not breaking the law. Yep. Now, I'm not going to enforce making people that I know personally have ID. If somebody comes to me and I know who these people are, and that's the reason why the precincts are set up the way they're set up, I just can't imagine asking someone that I actually physically know for identification.
Yep. All right. Well, we're going to keep following the story. If they'd passed this law and said 15 years from now or 10 years from now, you need to have this ID, given people a lengthy period of time to satisfy it, that would have been one thing. To do it this proximate to the election with a clear intent to keep certain voters from showing up is anti-democratic. It's not what this nation's all about. All right, Christopher Broach, Democratic elections judge in Delaware County, Pennsylvania. Mike Papantonio, host of Ring of Fire Radio. Thank you both for your time tonight.
Thank you, Governor.
Thank you.